Welcome back to Coding at Home. Today we are gonna play a competitive game which is called Catch the Robot. The goal is to catch the robot of the other team by going in the same box in which it is. But the risk is that the other team's robot catches our robot. So there is some kind of strategy that we have to put in place in order to be able to reach the box in which the other robot is without being reached by the other robot. And there is also some randomness, because the only way we have to provide instructions to the robot is by drawing cards from a shuffled deck. So, for instance, let me just provide an example. If I take five cards and at each turn each team has just five cards in hands, like the five that I'm showing right now, I can decide how many cards to play and in which order. So for instance, assuming that my team is the light blue team, I can decide to move forward, turn left, move forward and turn right. So, move forward, turn left, move forward, turn right. And this is the effect of these four cards played in sequence. Okay, so as you see, I have decided how many cards to play and in which order. At next turn, I will take from the deck, I will draw from the deck the same number of cards that I played in order to restart with five cards that provide enough degrees of freedom to implement my strategy. Okay, Anna, can we play?
Yes.
Okay, could you please shuffle the deck again?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. The two teams start from opposite corners of the checkered board, and as usual, this game can be played either on table or on the floor. If it is played on the floor, it is better to use larger cards in order to be better seen by all of the players. Okay, we take one card each, two, three, four, and five. Okay, you can move first. So those are our cards, so you play with me against Anna. Okay. So, as you can see, we have these two cards, which are not so useful at this time, but we could decide to play them in order to have the chance of drawing other cards from the deck. Let's try to implement this strategy and see what happens. So, I could... this way, which means move forward, turn right. Okay, let me take all these cards off the table. Here they are. Move forward, turn left. That's it?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. No, our cards are not that useful this time, so let me... I'm at risk, because if I play two of them, I go to the border, and facing the border of the checkered board. This means that if in the next turn I will draw again just move forward cards, so I'm also telling Anna that I have just move forward cards in hands, I risk to be unable to move. And being unable to move means two possible things depending on the rules you are playing with. The the obvious consequence is that you provide an advantage to the opponent. But it is also possible to decide that if one of the two teams is unable to move, it just loses the game. Okay? But this time, let me say that I try to play the two, and this is my move. Okay. Then I have something to tell you when it's our turn. Okay. So apparently this is good news, but not so good, because I can just play this card, which means turning left, and I'm still facing the border. Anna. From what you are doing, I assume that you have just turned left and turned right cards.
Yes.
The ones that I deserve. Okay. This is very good, actually. This is very good. Turn left. Move forward. While Anna is thinking that their strategy, I have something to tell you, because I told you that when the robot is just facing the border and cannot move, it can either lose the game or just pass the turn to the other team. But the two situations are the same, because if I have no cards to play, I cannot get other cards from the deck. So this means that I'm stuck in that position and I can just wait to be catched by the opponent. Okay? So you are trying to escape from our robot. Okay, so let's. We are at risk, but possibly in much better shape than. Anna won the game. Okay. Well done, Anna.
Thank you.
Okay. I'd like also to show you how to play the same game without a deck of cards. This can be done by using just some paper and four colors, actually three colors. I'll make a strange drawing just to point out that there are several sectors in this area that can take different colors. And now I start assigning colors to each of them, but at random. So one, two, three of them red, and then green, and then one red and one yellow. Why I'm assigning three green boxes and just one red and one yellow, because the deck is composed of 24 move forward cards, 8 turn right and 8 turn left. So this means that every 3 move forward there is one turn right and one turn left, and that's the same proportion that I'm using right now. So Anna, you can choose how to place 3 green dots and then a yellow one and a red one. Okay. My turn. Almost done. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, and the last one. Okay, this is now, oh, thank you, Anna. Now this is our way of drawing colors rather than cards from a deck, just colors from this strange shape. And Anna can close her eyes and just point her finger to choose a color. Okay, this is green, okay. And then again, green. Nothing. Not so easy, so you can make it bigger. Green again, and even the same that you drew before. Let's say that this is yellow, okay?
Last one.
Last one. Okay, green. So you have 4 greens and 1 yellow. And those are the 5 cards that she has in hands to move her robot. So if she decides to play 2 of them, for instance, just green and yellow means move forward and turn left. And next turn, she will have to just point her finger twice. Okay? So that's a way of playing without a deck. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.